now, my child. Come and light up your candle as I tell you a story. A tale of the prosperous land, Lumina. The land of Lumina is a place where many creatures live in jubilation and protected by a sacred light, a sensuous light, an entity who is both the ruler and the source of energy for Lumina. Under its light, fairies flock together in celebration and worship of the glory. They nourish the light with their songs and dances, and praises and poems. However, the peaceful days are ephemeral. Radiref, another entity of the opposite element, disrupts the balance and breaks Licentia into pieces. Stolen with him now is the core of life, buried deep into the very carcass of death, while the remnants are scattered all over Lumina, weak and ruined in hopelessness. He delves deep into the abyss, where all kinds of disequilibrium exist, where all hope is lost, never found. One fairy, howbeit, does not give up, and remains in pursuit of one creature. And he is our light seeker, Kimo.
I've crushed riots, foiled breakout attempts, and sent all those who opposed me to the gallows. You will not succeed.
What is that old saying? There's a first time for everything. A problem is a barrier. A challenge is surmountable. The dominoes are just beginning to fall. We must turn the people against Ivor. We must investigate this at once. In the best interests of Welkin, I must do the unthinkable.
I'm lost.
We have no time for diversions. This could be part of an elaborate trap. I am discreetly hunting for allies within the castle. The list you provided me earlier is most helpful.
You're a traitor, Lucien!
The plague and the slug will break down our walls!
Everyone in Welkin Castle is counting on us.
Ivor, Lucien, they all led me here.
Never forget, I hold the fate of Welkin in my palm.
Kembali. Hut, 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 hut